Hey, Joseph, thank you for asking the question in the group today about optimizing a variation listing. So Joseph wants to know, he says, I'm confused with optimizing a variation listing. Do the search terms need to be consistent with the parent dummy ASIN along with the child items? No, they don't. The parent is a dummy listing, just as you said, it's a holder of all the child listings, and the child listings can live on their own. So the cool thing about a variation listing is you can actually get more backend search terms in your listing overall because each of those child listings can have different search terms. So often when I'm writing variation listings for people, I'll provide them a whole list of keywords beyond the 249 bytes that fit in the search term, and that they can spread out throughout their variations. So don't forget your search terms as well to like misspell things like colors or keywords, and never use the same keywords that you use in the front end of your listing, meaning your title, your bullets, and your descriptions in the back end. And then those back end search terms should be in the format of word space, word space, word, no commas, no, any other symbols or anything like that. Okay. So what else? Do you individually optimize each child item, or are you just optimizing the main parent listings because they all lead to a page that has all the variations and child items? So again, you optimize the search terms, but often what I will do is I will create a parent listing with the same title, bullets, and description for all variations, right? I'll create the parent listing with those, and then I'll go to the variations tab and add in the SKU and the item number and all of that. And that automatically creates the children's listings. And then I go into each child item and add photos and backend keywords. And really pro tip for when you're optimizing your listings, guys, I'm going to remind you again, make sure that you're filling out the intended use and subject matter fields in your listing backend. Okay, you can use the product categorization tool. You just go to the help menu and type in product categorization and click use the tool. Type in your item type, and you're going to see all these categories and subcategories where your item could be. And you can use those words in your intended use and subject matter fields. So that is really great. And then in your more details tab, make sure you're filling that out. Make sure in your more details tab, and again, this would go in the parent, not the child, unless, like one thing is stainless steel material and another is rubber or something, but otherwise you just put it in the parent listing. You want to go into that more details tab and you want to make sure that you are filling out those more details items coincide with the categories on the left of Amazon when you're searching. So search for your item on Amazon and look down the left side and you're going to magically see some things that line up with the more details tab fields. So that is the secret to optimizing a variation listing. Thank you, Joseph, for asking the question. Keep them coming. Go sell some stuff.